This video is going to be about the equal additions algorithm for subtraction. And although the name for this is kind of complicated, the process is really fairly simple. It may be something you've already figured out for yourself. So here's an example. Let's say that you had to subtract, let's say, 17 minus 9. So you're finding the difference between 17 and 9. Now, at some point, you may have realized that if you just added a 1 to each of these numbers, your problem would be a whole lot easier. So I'm going to add a 1 to both numbers, and this is what we get. We add a 1 to the 17, we get 18. We add a 1 to the 9, we get 10. And then 18 minus 10 is just 8, which is the same thing I would get if I took 17 and subtracted 9. So really, all I'm doing is adding numbers onto the number I'm subtracting, as well as the other number, so that I can get, in this case, a 0 in the ones column, which makes it a lot easier to subtract. Now, if this process makes sense to you, let's go on and look at a somewhat harder problem with the same basic principle. So here I've got 782 minus 457. And the first thing I want to do is take the ones column, the units column, in the number I'm subtracting away, and turn that into a 0. So I'll turn that into a 0 by adding a 3 to that column, which means I have to add a 3 to the other number as well. So now I'm adding 3 to 782, and that's going to get me 785. And I'm adding a 3 to the 457, and that gets me 460. So now I've just got a 0 in that units column, which will make my subtraction easier. But I could make it even easier if I had a 0 in the tens column. So since I have 460, if I added 40 to this number, I would end up with, I would end up with 500. That's a nice number to subtract, which means I have to add 40 to the other number as well, to the 785. So I'll add 40 to that, and I'm going to get 825. Now when I do my subtraction, what I see is that 825 minus 500 just means that all I have to do is take the 5 from the 8, subtract the hundreds column. And that's going to give me 325. Okay, so just to review the process, I start out with a subtraction problem. And the first thing I want to do is, working with the number that I'm taking away, I want to add something to it to put a 0 in its units column. So when I had 457, I added a 3 to get a 0 in the units column. It gave me 460. Of course, I have to add 3 to the other number as well. So I added 3 to 782 and got 785. Now that I've got 460 as the number I'm taking away, I decide I'd like to get a 0 in the tens column. So to do that, I would have to add a 4 to the 6, or in other words, I want to add 40 to that whole number. When I add 40 to 460, I get 500. And when I add 40 to 785, I get 825. And now all I have to do is subtract my hundreds, 825 minus 500. So 8 minus 5 is 3, and I'll still have the 25. Okay, so that's the whole process. Take care. I'll see you next time.